small mammals play an inordinate role in ecosystem services. They are keystone species in many ways. They're an important prey base for carnivores, and not just mammalian carnivores, but raptors, fish will prey on small mammals.
This project was one of several pilot projects that started in 1992 when the National Park Service launched its long-term monitoring program. So it's one of the few that has been retained, and we're into it now for 23 years. The importance of having monitoring programs is based on the National Park Service mission. We have to preserve unimpaired our natural and cultural resources in the parks for future generations. And in order to do that, we have to know what's in the parks, we have to do an inventory, and we have to know how they're doing. So we have to monitor the status and trends of those resources. Because they're resident animals and they're available year-round, they're a good indicator of what's happening locally in the park. And they feed on the vegetation, so they respond to local changes in vegetation. So they can be a signal for us of climate change. If vegetation changes, the animals will follow those changes.
Every August, a group of students and researchers trap small mammals in Denali National Park as part of the Central Alaska Network Long-Term Monitoring Program. We set and check 400 Sherman live traps 3 times a day for 4 days to catch different species of voles. The traps are baited with microwave sunflower seeds and cotton squares for bedding, and covered with milk jugs to protect them from the rain. The seeds were microwaved to prevent sunflowers from growing in the park. We check traps at 6 a.m., 1 p.m., and 8 p.m. to get the animals out quickly. A closed door means we might have an animal. We peek into the trap, and if it's a small mammal, we transfer it to a bag for processing. The animals are identified by species, gender, and trap location. We tag them and check their weight. We also collect DNA swabs to better understand how interrelated the population is. Then, we release the animal, reset the trap, and repeat. If there's a death, we fill out a data tag and transfer it to the University of Alaska Museum Department of Mammalogy for proper burial. No, really, they become archival specimens in the museum's small mammal collection, where they are available for scientists and students to study. Once in the lab, we thaw the specimens and record the data of the animal using the field tag. After they're thawed, we take external measurements and weight, and then start dissecting. Once the gender is determined, we take tissue and organ samples for further research in the genetics lab. The next step is taking everything off the skeleton. From there, the species is identified by looking only at the teeth. The skeleton is dried and then sent to a room where beetle larvae clean it. The skeleton is then soaked in ammonia and water. After drying, the bones are numbered, put in vials, and then moved to the collection.
So we have redback voles here. This is probably a tundra vole, also called a root vole sometimes, Microtus economus. This is a redback vole, but as you can see on this one, it has brown color on its back instead of the red stripe that you see on the other one. This is a younger one, it's a little smaller. And this is another root vole.
Do you have a favorite small mammal?
To see the shrew.
Okay.
Even though I don't like prepping them, but I find them quite interesting. Just the way they look and the way they live, it's just interesting.
The benefits of working with partners and volunteering, resume builders for our underserved populations, and those students who may not have role models in post-secondary careers, especially tied to Department of Interior jobs.
I think it's important to get students in the parks because then you're spreading awareness to younger people who are looking for a career choice, that it's an option.
I think the younger generation needs to reconnect with nature. I think there's been sort of a move towards social media and that sort of thing, and there's nothing wrong with that, but I'd like to see people work with nature too and see nature as well as the electronic world.
It's really hard to get experience and to kind of break into it, and then everyone doesn't want to hire you because you don't have experience. So having the opportunity to come out here and do something like this and actually get experience on your resume is extremely valuable.
When I first came out here, I realized that it's a lot less intimidating as I thought it would be. and everyone's very friendly.
3, 2, 1, go.
Vole, 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 vole.
Shoo, shoo,
shoo, shoo. Vole, 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 vole. Shoo, 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 shoo. I'm gonna tag some voles. Only got 20 swabs in my pocket. I'm hunting, looking for a blackback. This is freaking awesome.
Head into the flats, like, what up?
I got a big hump, arms pumped up with some bait from the knack box.
Back into the upper flats, Hallie Hansen's super hot. Looking for some voles, maybe shrews, but we're hoping not. Keep doing that. Oh, there you go. You're up on your heels. Work it, girl. Okay, now.
Hey, Mama. Oh, yeah.